Hello everyone, our numerical is regarding design of unsymmetrical square footing. Statement is, design an isolated unsymmetrical square footing for a column size 500 into 500 mm, transmitting external load of 600 kN, moment is 30 kN/m, the safe bearing capacity of the soil is 120 kN/m, use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. So first of all, we have to write the data given. Axial load is represented by P is equal to 600 kN. Movement M is equal to 30 kN/m. Size of the column is 500 into 500 mm. Safe bearing capacity of the soil is Q is equal to 120 kN/m². For M20 concrete, value of the FCK will be 20 newton per square mm, and for Fe415 steel, value of the Fy will be equal to 450 newton per square mm. So we will start with the step one. Step one is to calculate the loads. So external load is given, P is equal to 600 kN. We have to add the self weight of the footing, and self weight of the footing is equal to 10% of the axial load, which is equal to 60 kN. And total service load is equal to PS. PS represents the total service load, is equal to PE. P means service load, axial load, plus P naught. P naught means self weight of the footing, which is equal to 600 plus 60 is equal to 660 kN. Second step is determination of area required for the footing. Area required for the footing is equal to total service load, which already we have calculated, divided by safe bearing capacity of the soil, which is given in a statement. So AR is equal to 660 divided by 120 is equal to 5.5 square meter. Because we are designing a square footing, we know that in square footing all sides are equal to each other. So side into side is equal to AR, which is area required, and side is equal to under root of AR, and value of AR is 5.5. From it we calculate 2.34 meter dimension of the one side, and we are taking it as 2.4 meter. So area provided according to 2.4 meter length is 2.4 into 2.4 is equal to 5.76 square mm. Now come to the step 3, which is eccentricity. What is eccentricity? Eccentricity is actually distance between line of action, distance between line of action to the CG of the footing area. I'm repeating my statement. Eccentricity is distance between the line of action, means line of 600 kN load is a line of action, which is a line of load, a line of action of load, to the CG of the footing. CG means center of gravity of the footing area, which is lies at the center of the footing. So distance between these two lines are known as eccentricity. How to calculate the eccentricity? We have a formula. It is represented by small e. Small e is equal to movement, which is given in the numerical. So movement divided by P. So due to this eccentricity, this movement is generated at the point of CG of the footing. So that is why given in the statement. So movement divided by P, P is axial load. So total centricity is 50 mm. 50 mm means the external load is 50 mm away from the CG of the footing. Okay. Step 4 is calculation of upward soil pressure, means the resistance against the load and the self weight by the soil towards upward direction. So upward soil pressure is small p is equal to service load divided by area of the footing, means area provided. So value of the P is 600 kN and area of footing is 5.76, which we have provided. So value of the P is 104.16 kN per square mm. And please note, the value of P should be less than the value of Q. Value of Q is safe bearing capacity of the soil. Safe bearing capacity of the soil should be greater than this upward soil pressure. Step 5. Calculation of depth from the one way shear. Now, this is a quite different from the books. So we have to calculate the depths from the different shear failures. So for that, first of all, we are considering one way shear consideration. We will calculate the depth from the one way shear consideration. For that, you have to read IS 456-2000, clause 40.2, page 72. The value is given, K into toy C should be greater than or equal to toy V. What is toy C? Toy C is a design shear strength of concrete. Toy V is nominal shear stress. what is VU1? VU1 is shear force at the critical section into 1.5 means it is a factored V. It is a factored shear force. So that's why in limit state method, we are going to multiply with 1.5. So B is a width of the footing and D is a effective depth of the footing. These three parameters comes from here because toy V is equal to VU1 divided by capital B into D. And here B is width of footing. So critical section for the one-way shear. One-way shear, a critical section for the one-way shear is at distance D. D means effective depth from the face of the column, shear force at section. In one-way shear, critical section for the one-way shear is at distance D from the face of the column, shear force at that section. So here it is a diagram of the one-way shear. So one-way shear diagram means one-way shear is a critical section. Section is a critical at the distance D from the face of the column. So this shaded portion is a critical section. So we have to calculate the shear value for this critical portion, right? So how can we calculate this value? Actually, the concept comes from, now we have to calculate toy V is equal to VU1 over B into D. We are going to calculate VU1. For VU1, please see this concept. We know that stress is equal to load over area and load is equal to stress into area. And here in one-way shear, in our case, our load is V, our stress is P, P means upward soil pressure, and area is shaded area of the critical section, area of this section, shaded area section, right? And area is equal to L into B, and we know the L is equal to this length. L means this length of the shaded area, and B is given already 2.4. We have to calculate this length of the shaded area. So to calculate this length, we are following this. So VU1 is equal to upward soil pressure, which is stress into B. We have to calculate stress into area. In area, we have two dimensions, L into B. B we already have calculated. To have to calculate the L, come here. So L is total distance 2.4 minus 0.9 minus 0.5 minus D is equal to this length, right? So it is 2.4 is a total distance minus this length 0.9 minus this length 0.5 minus D, and we are here. So this length is equal to this equation. So V1 is equal to 250 minus 250 D, and VU1, it is multiplied, whole equation will be multiplied by the 1.5. the equation is 735 minus 735 D. So I hope you all understand that how we calculate VU1. So come to the nominal shear stress. Equation was toy V is equal to VU1, which we have calculated 350 minus 350 into D, this equation. And B is 2.4, we know, and D is not calculated. We have to calculate the D, small d, which is depth of the footing. So please see, we have to calculate this equation that K into toy C should be greater than toy V. We have calculated equation for the toy V, which is equal to this. Now we have to calculate K into toy C. K is always constant, which will be taken as 1. And to calculate toy C, please follow IS code 456, page 73, table 19. So in this, we can assume any value from the first two or first three columns or rows. So this is the value of the percentage of the steel. This is the value of PT. So PT is equal to 100 into AS over BD. So for example, we are considering value of the PT is 0.25. For 0.25, what should be the shear strength of the concrete if we are using M20 concrete, because we are using M20 concrete in our numerical. So it is 0.25 and it is 0.36, right? So assume percentage of steel is 0.25, and for M20 concrete, value of toy C is equal to 0.36 newton per square mm, and K is equal to 1. This is assumed as 1. So design shear strength of the concrete is K into tau C is equal to 0.36 Newton per square mm, right? Now, to calculate the depth of the footing, we are equating both the equation 360. We have converted it into 360 kilonewton per square per meter square, and is equal to 375 minus 375 d divided by 2.4 into d. So here, from here, this equation we are calculating. We calculated d, which is 302, right? So we are providing the value of the d is 310 mm approximately. So effective cover is 75. So overall depth will be equal to 385. So next step is calculation of depth from the two-way shear consideration. See, we have calculated effective depth from the one-way shear consideration. Now we will check, is this depth of 310 mm is sufficient to carry the two-way shear load, two-way shear failure? So if it is possible, so we will proceed with same depth. If it is not, so we have to calculate the new depth, right? So in two-way shear consideration, the critical section for the two-way shear consideration is at distance d by 2 along the periphery of the columns. Means from the periphery of the columns, each side means four sides of the column, at the distance d by 2, the shaded portion is critical section in the two-way shear, right? So the equation to calculate the depth will remain same. Now it is Ks into tau C should be greater than tau V. So what is Ks? To calculate the value of Ks, please see page number 59, IS 456. Here it is. Ks is equal to 0.5 into beta C, but it should be not greater than 1. But what is beta C? Beta C is the ratio of the short side of the column to the long side of the column. Right, and for the tau C in limit state method, two-way shear limit state method, tau C should be equal to 0.25 under root FCK. FCK is already given, which is M20, 20 Newton per square mm. So Ks into tau B should be greater than tau V. Obviously, substitute of the tau V is equal to VU2 divided by B naught into D. I will explain what is B naught here. Right. So to calculate the V2 means shear force. To calculate the shear force V2, please see again this concept. So we know that stress is equal to load over area, load is equal to stress into area, and here in two-way shear, load is V2, stress is P, and area is shaded area of critical section. For us, area should be shaded area of the critical section, right? So how can we calculate the shaded area? It's a very basic geometry. So shaded area is equal to plan area of footing, total plan area of the footing, minus plan area of the non-shaded portion. Minus plan area of the non-shaded portion, you will get the answer of shaded area. Right? So here, from this equation, we can calculate the value of V2. V2 is 570 into 7.7 kilonewton, and VU2 is obviously multiplied by 1.5 is equal to 796.16 kilonewton. So now we calculate the value of VU2 in the two-way shear. We know the value of D from the one-way shear is equal to 310. Now what is B0? B naught is critical perimeter. Critical perimeter means this length, this perimeter, this and this. These are four dimensions which are equal, right? What are these dimensions are? These dimensions are B plus D, four sides multiplied by 4. What is B? B is column of width plus D by 2 plus D by 2, both sides. D by 2 plus B plus D by 2 is equal to B plus D. D by 2 plus D by 2 is equal to D. So equation is B plus D. So we have four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we are multiplying the critical perimeter into by 4. Right? So B naught is 3.24 meter So we have calculated the value VU2, V0 and DE, we will consider 310. From this equation, we have calculated the value for TV is nominal shear stress is equal to 775.304 kilonewton per square meter. We are going to convert it into kilonewton per square mm. And for value of KS into tau SE is equal to 1.118 kilonewton per mm square. How this value comes? So we know, as I already shown in the IS code, KS is equal to 0.5 into beta C. What is beta C? It's a short side of the column, which is already given 0.5. Long side of the column, obviously, square column is 0.5. So value of this is 1. Beta C is 1. And 0.5 plus 1 is equal to 1.5. But we cannot take it as more than 1. So we are considering the value of KS is 1. So tau C is equal to 0.25 under root FCK. And FCK's values is M20. So for M20, FCK will be 20. And the equation will be equal to 1.118 Newton per mm square. So KS is 1, tau C is 1.118 and is equal to 0.00118 kilonewton per square mm. So value of KS into tau C is greater than tau V. So value of tau V is 0.00775 is a value of tau V, and the value of the tau C is 0.0018. So it is greater than the tau V. Hence, depth of footing calculated from the one-way shear consideration is suitable to carry the two-way shear too. So now step 7 is a third consideration to check our depth, because depth is the most important factor to design the footing. So calculation of depth now from the last parameter is bending consideration. First we calculated from one way shear consideration, we calculated it 310 mm, which is sufficient to carry the two way shear. Now we will check the same depth for the bending consideration. So please kindly note to do this step. In this case, in the case of unsymmetrical footing, long side means the distance from the column face to the edge of the footing, which is longer, that will be taken as bending moment consideration. So in our footing, please see the diagram. In the diagram, the right face of the footing is greater than from the left face of the footing. Right, so we will take this side to calculate the bending moment consideration. How to calculate bending moment for the footing? To know this, please read clause 34.2.3.1 and 0.2 also. Read both the clause, it will be clarified to all. Right, IS code 456, page number 64 to 65. So basically, what is moment? Moment is load into area, right? So we are considering the maximum moment will be generated at the face of the column. So we have to calculate the maximum bending moment. Maximum bending moment calculate karne ke liye kya hai? We have a given is load is UDL. To calculate the bending moment due to UDL at the face of the column, formula will be W into L, which is total load, into L by 2, half of the this length, right? So this is the basic formula, into B. So we are also considering the width across the footing. So this, for this multiplication of the B, the explanation is given in the page number 64 and 65, clause 34.2.1, right? So from here we calculate the moment. So moment is, so sorry, I am explaining again, the value of W is 104.6, value of the L is 1000 mm, and L by 2 is 1000 by 2, into B is width of the footing is 2.4. Simply multiply the footing, multiply this moment by the width of the footing. So we have value 124.992 kilonewton meter, and MU is multiplied by the 1.5, and the value of MU is 187.488 kilonewton meter. Now come for the minimum required depth to carry this maximum bending moment. So for this we have to equate MU is equal to MU limb. MU is 187.488 into 10 to the power 6. We convert it into Newton meter is equal to, we know for FE415, MU limb is equal to equation 0.138 into FCK is 20, M20, and B is 2400 mm, and D we have to calculate, right? For the maximum depth, for the maximum bending moment. So for maximum bending moment, which is 187.488, to bear this bending moment, the minimum depth of footing is required 168.23, but we have calculated for one way shear it is 310, which is same for the two way shear. So hence we are in the safe zone. So we will proceed with the depth of 310 mm. So depth, minimum required depth for the maximum bending moment is 168, which is less than, which already we are taking depth is 310 mm. So hence we are in a safe zone with our depth. So our depth is, which we adopted, is 310. Effective cover for the footing is 75 mm. So overall depth capital D is equal to 385 mm, right? So now we are towards the last steps of the numerical of the design. So now comes for the design of reinforcement. So we first step is we have to calculate directly area, cross-sectional area required for the steel. So it is, equation is, this is the basic formula. So we have to remember this formula. It is 0.5 FCK divided by FY bracketed 1 minus under root and this, so on, right? So we have to put the values which we already have calculated, which we already have calculated previously. So the value is 0.5, FCK is 20, FY is 415, and MU is maximum bending moment, which is 187 into 10 to the power 6. We have converted into the Newton mm. FCK is again 20, B is the width of the footing, which is 2400, and D square means depth of the footing, which already we have adopted, 310 mm. Right, into B again width of the footing, into 310 depth of the footing, right? From here we calculate the area of the steel is 1762.59 square mm. So for this cross section area we have to choose the steel. If we are designing a footing, so basically the average dia of the steel will be 16 mm for the footing. So we are providing 16 mm dia bars for the footing, and for these bars what should be the spacing of the bar, center to center distance of the bar in the footing. So spacing is equal to AFI. AFI is cross sectional area of the steel which we are providing. So we are providing 16 mm dia of the steel. So for this area of the cross sectional area of the bar is 201 mm divided by total cross section area, which we have calculated 1762.59, into B. B is the width of the footing. Okay, so spacing we calculated is 273. So we are providing 270 mm center to center. So the writing style should be like this: 17 mm dia at the rate 270 mm center to center distance, right? So here it is the diagram or sketch for the steel providing. This is the area of the plan area of the footing. So we are providing in the both directions. Steel is 16 mm dia at the rate 270 mm center to center, right? So this green steel, green lines are showing only steel for the footing,